latest trip to Northern Norway was really epic, and I'm really looking forward to sharing it with you guys. This place is something else. It's something really special, and I cannot wait to show you guys what I've learned about this place and what you can expect in the future if you come along. And I have a really special announcement in the end of this video. So hang on and see you on the water. We arrived at the camp at the most amazing spot, and as the sun was setting, in the most spectacular way I've ever seen.
It's
so amazing. You could just tell that this was the beginning of something very special, and the whole team was excited to see what the next days would bring. The next morning we got up early to get ready for the first day underwater, and man, did we get blessed with some perfect conditions. The sun was shining and there was no wind at all. The visibility was around 12 meters and exactly what we have been hoping for at this time of the year. Everybody was ready for some Nordic sunshine reggae, and all the gear was packed and ready to go for a long day at sea. Fishing equipment, wetsuits, spear guns, we had it all. Pretty soon we arrived to the first spot of the day, and everybody was impressed by the sight. We could not wait to get in the water. I was boating at the first hour of our trip, but I was just as stoked as the rest of the team, and I couldn't wait until it was my turn to get in the water and see all the amazing underwater sceneries.
Sailor og valer og andre.
But I had to wait because I was the boatie and I was in charge of the safety of the whole team.
Er det god sigt, Michael? Er det god sigt?
Ja!
Fedt!
As time went by, I was getting pretty excited and I was just waiting for the call. Somebody shouting halibut, and I was expecting this moment to happen at any time.
Getting in the water, enjoying this beautiful, beautiful landscape. So, see you in the water.
But nothing happened until a couple of guys met some seals swimming around, being friendly, curious, and just wanted to have a look at us because we were in their backyard. So we decided to take a dive with them and play around a bit before heading to another spot to try to find some fish for the dinner table. Arriving at the next spot, defined by some underwater structures with lots of current and kelp forests, we found a lot of small cold fish, and that is often a really good sign. Bigger fish might be around as well. Diving between these rock formations was just absolutely amazing and a great experience in itself. So we enjoyed the first session of diving, got some good footage, and some decent fish, and was pretty happy about the way this trip had begun.
Første fisk i Norge den her gang. Rødspæt. Lækkert. Hvor kæft, den flot, mand. Hvad tror du, den vejer?
Næsten 3 kilo.
Jeg tror, den vejer 3 kilo. 66 centimeter. Flot fisk.
Ja.
Tillykke.
Tak.
Camp.
But no halibut on the first day, so we had to get back to camp, get some food in the restaurant, and get some sleep, get ready for the next day.
What a day. And look at that. Yes.
And the next day was an excellent opportunity to get some new ground color. So we took off early the next morning to get the most out of the beautiful day and the perfect conditions we had 2 days in a row.
Wow.
Incredible conditions. You cannot ask for any more than that in Northern Norway.
God tur. Ja.
Tak.
We decided to go for halibut in the morning, and we expected to be able to find these amazing fish in the shallow water between some islands, despite the water temperature was just a little too high for us to get the perfect conditions for finding halibut in shallow waters.
Just waiting for us today in this beautiful weather. Oh my god.
I don't know if you can see it on the camera, guys, but the visibility is really nice. You can see the bottom pretty easily here. This is about 6 meters, so it's not that deep, but wow. Look at that. Amazing.
Nevertheless, if you don't try, you don't win, and we all would really like to see how this beautiful place was looking on the surface. Because from the boat, it looked like something out of a movie. It was so amazing, really incredible. For those of you that haven't been able to go spearfishing or fishing for halibut, it's not an easy task. You need to make sure that you know what you're doing and how to get the fish. So you have to expect to put a lot of time and energy into this project. But there's no guarantees, so when you go searching for these tasty fish, the queen of the Nordic waters, you have to be patient. But the reward in the end is just so satisfying. The fish was staying deeper than expected because of a shift in the water temperature, but I was in my wetsuit and I had my mind set on spearing halibut for this trip, so I kept doing my best. And suddenly I see the shape of something that looks exactly like the shape of a halibut. And at this point of time, I could not believe that I might get a chance as well to get a halibut. Something that I have been looking for all of this time. Although I got a good hold of the fish, I didn't slow it and I wouldn't risk losing the fish because I didn't feel confident enough at this point of time to fight the fish with only one spear in it. So I got back to the surface and I shouted out loud, "Halibut!" to get the body as fast as I could to bring me another spear gun because I needed this second shot to get the fish safely on the boat. Marius and Martin quickly assisted with a second shot. And the fish was secured and safely brought into the boat. And guys, I'm gonna show you a super fun little tradition at this fishing camp. When you get a halibut, this camp is very aware of the importance of sustainability. So we only take the amount of fish that we need, and at the same time, we protect all the big fish that's really important for the ecosystem. So we only go for the medium-sized fish that's above the legal minimum size and up until 130 centimeters. A fish between the legal minimum size and 130 centimeters is the perfect and most tasty fish to eat. So that's the best fish to take home for the dinner table as well. The tradition about sharing the experience with other guys is only one part of what I'm talking about. The other part of the tradition includes a little ceremonial act of honoring the fish by leaving the tail of the fish on the wall of fins to celebrate the beautiful catch of the day. This fish is absolutely the best eating quality that you can imagine, and you should definitely take some nice fillets of fish with you if you decide to go on a trip like this. So guys, if you want to travel with us to this very special place in the world, we can make your game fish adventures come true in the future. This is a totally new opportunity that we've got from this year. We have the opportunity to travel in groups of four or more people. So please read the descriptions below if you want to join us for another Nordic game fish adventure. And like and subscribe if you want to get notified when we upload new videos. It's totally free and it's a great way to support our channel.
Well guys, that's it for another episode. This has been one heck of an adventure. So epic weather and nice, nice spearfishing. We couldn't ask for more. The weather is perfect. And thank you for watching guys. See you on the next one.